Hi everybody, welcome back. This is Mr. Campbell from MrCampbellRocks.com. Today I'm going to show you how to create office hours using Google Classroom. These can be one-time office hours. These can be the same office hours throughout the week. You can also create appointment slots. That's a little bit different in another tutorial, but there's a lot of things that you can do with Google Calendar and Google Classroom. So let's get started. So the first thing that I'm gonna show you is this is the teacher side, right, of Google Classroom. And then I also have my son as a student in the student side. So I'll show you what that looks like on both sides. It's actually pretty similar. So the first thing that you'll do is when you get to Google Classroom, you're gonna be basically in your stream. So when you click on classwork up here at the top, there's gonna be a little option here where it says Google Calendar. So you're gonna click on Google Calendar. And what you'll see here is you'll actually take you to your Google Calendar that you have with your district or your school account. Now, it's important that you understand that a lot of the new Google Meet features and some of those updates that are coming will only be available in the G Suite Enterprise for education, not the free education version. So if this doesn't work for you and you're like, oh, why aren't these there? That's why. So what we're gonna do is we are going to add a time. Let's say that we are doing remote school every other day, or we're having half our kids one day, half the other day, or maybe we're going Monday through Thursday and we're having Fridays as a cleaning day or a catch-up day. That's what our district is doing. So I wanna have office hours on every Friday from 10 until 12. So I have some basic options here, and I'm just gonna type in office hours for, let's just say, third grade. So when I have these options, I can click on more options and it's gonna give me a few more items. And I need to point out some of the things. This is where you could actually have the office hours repeating. When you have repeating office hours, that Google Meet code is the same. And so it will sit there a week in advance, a week in advance. As of right now, that can get you in some trouble because students could get in to the Meet without you there. Once the updates happen with Google Meet, that should be fine and they shouldn't be able to get in. So just so you're aware, but you can have this repeat every week. You can have it every other week, however you want to set that up. But once we have it here, you'll see that I have this option here to add Google Meet video conferencing. So I'm going to add that right there. It's going to create a Google Meet link, and you can see right there, there's the Google Meet link and it's up to 250 participants. Now for me, it defaulted to my test class. Some of you, it may default to your personal calendar. You wanna make sure that it is in your Google Classroom calendar. You don't need to share this out on any other calendar or anything like that because it's gonna show up in the calendar on Google Classroom. So we're gonna click there, the test class for Google Tutorials, and I have it as blue. I don't need to add guests because all of the students in the class will have access to this. So then I'm gonna click save. And then you'll see that it's going to show up here. So if I go back to my Google Classroom and click on Google Calendar, it's going to take me there. And there's our item right there. So when I slide over to the student view, so I'm just going to slide over. This is the student view here. And let me just refresh to make sure that everything went through. When I click on Google Calendar, you'll see that office hours show up right there for the students. Now, so the student can click on this link, join with Google Meet. So we're gonna join as a student, and you'll see here that this is the background here, so I'm going to mute that and take the video away. I'm gonna click on join now. So that's his little symbol, right? So he's in the mini. I'm gonna go back to the teacher view, click on it, join the Google Meet. And you'll see that the student is already in this call. Obviously, I would want to be here first. So now I'm gonna join the call, and you can see that there's two of us in the call. You can have these open office hours set to whatever time that you want. I recommend to be successful with this is to let them know of the time, but don't actually create the meet until the morning of or 10 minutes before you're ready to jump in. That way you don't have students jumping in before you and you don't have to worry about any sort of issues happening that way. When the update happens, they shouldn't be able to join without your permission. If you found value in this tutorial, go ahead and like and subscribe.
Thank you for watching this video all the way till the end, and thank you for what you do for kids on a daily basis. If this video saved you time, energy, and frustration, go ahead and like, subscribe, and share it with your teacher friends. You can subscribe by clicking up here, or you can watch another video either here or here. Again, I love you, I appreciate you, and I'm glad that you're here.